Remembering my very successful visit to your country, once again I'd like to express gratitude for hospitality. I have very good memories of the visit, very good results, and of course the documents which were signed, they strengthen our partnership, especially the document about the new format of strategic partnership between our countries. And also my meetings with the President, with Prime Minister, with heads of two chambers of parliament, mayor of Rome, all were very positive.
You had the delegation also a couple of days ago from...
I just received the delegation from parliament, from different political groups, and had led by the deputy chairman of parliament. They visited Agdam, they visited Ganja. I was very touched by the decision to visit the cities which one suffered during the times of occupation, another suffered during the war, was hit by ballistic missiles and with many, many victims. So, talking about our relations, I'm sure that they will have a great future, because so far we achieved great success in political, economic area, energy security area. Soon we will complete the final part of the Southern Gas Corridor. And thus, Italy and Azerbaijan will be very close partners in energy for decades ahead. This is a remarkable achievement of our joint efforts, of the efforts of the very broad group of countries. And as you know, every year we organize in Baku Advisory Council of the Southern Gas Corridor. Italy always is present on a high level, and these meetings also helped us in order to build this historical pipeline of the length of 3,500 kilometers. So on one end is Baku, on the other end is Italy. And of course we are looking forward to deepen our cooperation. I know that your agenda today will be also very busy. And we want to take advantage of the excellent political relations between our countries to address issues of economic cooperation and involvement of more Italian companies into activity in Azerbaijan in the traditional areas, and also with respect to our big plans to restore the destroyed cities of Azerbaijan. Because we need to build new infrastructure, new roads, new railway lines, new airports, new hospitals, new schools, because Armenians destroyed everything. And these videos are now available, so they leveled to ground our cities, behaved like barbarians, and this once again demonstrates their aggressive policy towards Azerbaijan. So we already started. That made the first steps in the area of reconstruction. First contracts have already been signed. And as I said, we will work on the liberated lands with companies from friendly countries. The first contracts were signed with Turkish companies. This is natural because Turkey is our brotherly country. I hope that the next contracts will be signed with Italian companies. And during
the same.
Yes. And that will be also natural because Italy is a very close friend to Azerbaijan. During long time of our diplomatic relations, and especially during the war, we felt your position, and the fact that your parliamentarians visit Azerbaijan less than in 1 month after the war stopped demonstrates our strong friendly relations, and we highly value this gesture of solidarity, gesture of support. The delegation which I met 2 days ago was the first delegation from the European Union area visiting us after the war. And I'm sure that these gestures of friendship will have a practical implementation, because today we talk about not only energy sector but mainly non-energy sector, the big potential in the liberated lands for agriculture, for tourism, for creation of renewable sources of energy, and as I said already, the huge infrastructure projects. We are now preparing our plan for rehabilitation and reconstruction of those territories. And I'm sure that we will work very successfully. I like also to mention that the visit of Italian parliamentarians was very highly valued in Azerbaijani society, because as you can imagine, people are very attentive and very sensitive to all the signs of support, and all the society, they accepted this visit as a sign of support. And also what people say, and I share their view, is that while some of your neighbors in parliament adopt strange resolutions recognizing Nagorno-Karabakh, Italian parliamentarians come to Agdam, come to Ganja, to demonstrate their respect to Azerbaijan, to demonstrate solidarity to the sufferings of Azerbaijani people. And with respect to the recognition of Nagorno-Karabakh, everybody knows that even Armenia did not recognize this illegal structure. Therefore, if some country wants to recognize Nagorno-Karabakh, they can make some steps inside their own country. They can provide some land in their own country and to create a second Armenian state within their own country, not in Azerbaijan. So this once again shows that friendship between our countries and a mutual positive attitude between our peoples have already transformed into reality. And we also consider your visit as a good sign of that. I'm sure that there will be very positive outcomes of your visit, and we will structure properly the agenda for the next at least 5-10 years of strong cooperation in all the areas. So once again, welcome to Azerbaijan.
Thank you, Mr. President. First of all, let me tell you that it's an honor for me to be here today, and I'm really grateful to your government for the arrangement of this just 24 hours, but very full in schedule. So yesterday I already met the Minister of Foreign Affairs. It was a great pleasure for me. We exchanged a lot in any field, and today I will have the chance to meet other ministers, and that's a real sign of this cooperation that is in place between among us. Let me first of all convey to you and your people our sympathy for the victims of the war. That was really a tough one, and we followed with a great concern from Italy. You cannot even imagine how much in Italy this war was felt, and because we feel this area of the world being so close to us in any sense. So we really try to avoid any political understanding of the war, and we just try to tell the truth to the country of what was going on, and our political positioning that I'm glad you recognize as positive was just based on UN resolutions and everything that was already written on the papers, I will say. Obviously, it was a real relief for us when this ceasefire was signed. We think that it was the first and most important thing, because when you stop having victims, it's always a positive thing for everyone. And now we really offer our availability and capability on helping going forward on the points of the trilateral declaration, that we think is a good starting point for everything that you have to do right now, since now on.